Hi, I'm Dr. Charles E. Rogers, Senior Pastor of Hope Community Church. We're excited week after week, knowing that you have the opportunity to join us in our worship experience through the medium of television. As you know, through television, we're only able to provide a small sampling of the incredible worship that goes on at Hope Community. And we want to invite you to come out and be with us. We're located at 1111 Pulaski Pike, right here in the center of Huntsville, Alabama. We'd just be glad to have you and your entire family coming and be a part of our worship experience. God bless you. We're the Hope Community Church, the church where everybody's somebody and no one is a stranger. Be blessed.
Come here, Michael, since you came up here. I'm trying to close. I ain't about to testify for you. Come here, Deacon. You know, sometimes you got to learn how to celebrate the people in front of you. Because, you know, this room is full of stories. Oh, God, I wish I had some time. I don't have time to preach. But, honey, you know, everybody who's standing up don't look like, it don't mean they ain't been knocked down. I don't know. You don't let this two-piece fool you. The enemy's done everything he could to make me cuckoo. I'm glad I'm still here. Honey, if it wasn't for the goodness of the Lord, you couldn't sit this close to me. If it wasn't for his mercy, if it wasn't the Lord, I don't know. There's a few folk in here you ought to give a tip to every Sunday you come. Say, you still saved? I can't believe you still saved. You mean to tell me you still praising? I can't believe you still pray. You mean to tell me you ain't locked up? I can't believe you ain't locked. Go ahead and pull on your neighbor and say, I can't believe you still love him. I can't believe you done got this sensitive. I can't believe you ain't cussing no more and joking no more and not drinking no more. I don't believe it. But you keep coming back. You keep coming back. With all the stuff that tried to knock you out, you keep coming back. You know, I'm glad when the people of God come into the house of God. Don't tell me what God can't do. I've been to 2 drug rehabs. You think it's too late for me? I just know that my God is able. He's able. Don't tell me what he can't do, because he's able to do anything. Anything but fail. You might let him fail, but I'm the one that keeps stepping into the same place, believing God for the same thing. I'm like the man at the pool of Bethesda. I believe that someday God's gonna trouble the waters, and the first one in, he's gonna be healed. I plan on being first. It may not be this week, it may not be next week, but the reason I keep coming, that I still believe that he's going to come. God, I feel preaching. Come and hook up. You see, because we all here for the same thing, but we came from different places. Oh God. See, you know, see, this is what you miss. You know, you're looking at me 30 years later, and I ought to look like I better. Because if you, I don't care how bad you're wounded, you ought to get better after 30 years. But this is Joker over here now, God help him. Lord have mercy. He still got some stuff he's shaking off. You understand? Go ahead and throw your hand up now. Say, yeah, that's me. Yeah. You see, because you don't know the testimonies in this room. That's why you don't know nothing about the miracles of God. That's why you give up every time somebody say, your rent due Friday, and you ain't going, if you don't have it, I'm going to put you out. Put me out. Don't you know that I should be crazy? I should already be dead. You put me out, God will bring me in. You rascal, you, I don't know. And here he is. Put your hand off your chest. This is me preaching. And then here he is. I come to this place 34 years ago, and God saves me. But look at God. God ain't through saving. How long you been saved, Deacon? I mean, you know, since you've been saved the first time. You know, when you got saved the first time. I ain't talking about when you backslid and came up. 14 years. Let me tell you something. Y'all look at him now. Honey, you didn't want to know him 14, 15 years ago. You see, you really don't. Because this joker here, I wish I had some time. This joker right here, oh my God. If you told him 15 years ago he was going to be a deacon, honey, he'd have said, thank you. That's what I want. I'm already a deacon. Because I've been in hospital with him when his head went through a windshield. I don't know. You still got scars? Yeah. You see, because when God saved you, baby, you ought to be able to show your scars. When he does good things for you, there ought to be something in your life. Just say, you don't believe it? See right here? This is when I should have been dead. But God made a way out of no way. But look at him now. You can come and push him. You can come and talk about him, and he'll talk about Jesus. Can't nobody do that but Jesus. Now some of you sitting here like you don't love the person next to you. Baby, it's because you don't know what they've been through. But God told me to tell you, we all here for the same thing, and we came from different places, but hitherto have the Lord helped us. His mercy endures forever. Slap five people, high five, and say, ain't been nothing but mercy. You can't look at me funny. It ain't been nothing but mercy. I keep coming back because of his mercy. I didn't lose my mind because of his mercy. It's just been. I'm going to read from verse number 23. I feel the sweet presence of the Lord in the house. We used to sing a part that says, Jesus knows my every weakness. Aren't you glad he knows? Well, come on and let's read. Then the Lord of the Philistines gathered them together for to offer a great sacrifice to Dagon, their God, and to rejoice, for they said, our God had delivered Samson, our enemy, into our hand. And when the people saw him, they praised their God. Well, they said, our God had delivered into our hands our enemy and the destroyer of our country, which slew many of us. And it came to pass when their hearts were merry that they said, call for Samson that he may make us sport. And they called for Samson out of the prison house. And he made them sport, and they set him between the pillars. And Samson said unto the lad that held him by the hand, suffer me that I pray that I may feel the pillars whereupon the house standeth, that I may lean upon them. Now the house was full of men and women, and all the lords of the Philistines were there. And there were upon the roof upon about 3,000 men and women, and that beheld while Samson made sport. And Samson called unto the Lord and said, O Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once, O God, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes. And Samson took hold of the two middle pillars upon which the house stood and on which it was borne up, of the one with his right hand and of the other with his left. And Samson said, let me die with the Philistines. He bowed himself with all his might. And the house fell upon the lords and upon all the people that were therein. So the dead which he slew at his death were more than they which he slew in his life. And the church said, amen. My God. Before you seat, I know you're tired. His enemy rejoiced. They said, God has delivered us from our enemy. He's put him in our hand. I want you to look at your neighbor before you sit down and say, neighbor, I just keep coming back. Now you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I don't even have time to tell you all the stuff I come back from. I just keep coming back. But there's some things that I never should be back that I've been in. Some things that have nothing to do with me and some things that was all my fault. But is there anybody in here who's just glad that regardless of what you've been in, that God keeps bringing you back? Sometimes I even surprise myself because some things that happened was so bad, I didn't think I'd ever get back. Didn't think I'd ever smile again or dance again or praise again. But look at that neighbor one more time and say, can you see I'm back? I wish I had some help already. Go ahead and tell him I shouldn't be back, but I'm back. Back from the deep. Back from almost being dead. Back from folks writing me off. Back from rumors. Back from being lied on. and everybody wasn't lying. Sometimes I was just told on. But aren't you glad that you're back? Nudge him again and say, we're going to have church today because the Lord let me back. God, I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. Everybody don't know nothing about that, but I'm glad to be back. Cynthia Kersee, in her book Unstoppable, introduced us to 45 people who overcome tremendous obstacles, things that stood between them and their destiny, them and their goal, and persevered until they made it. She called it the unstoppable spirit. Spirit in people that refuse to let anything cause them to miss their moment and miss their purpose. Because she discovered that if you're going to persevere, there has to be something within you that will keep on coming, even though situations will dictate your not making it when you get there. When all the odds are against you, and people are against you, and circumstances are against you, there has to be something inside of you that keeps saying, but I can. Even if I get knocked down, I can. Even if everything is against me, I can. And I tell you something else, sometimes even if I get knocked out, I still can. People who have been anointed by God are given the unstoppable spirit that tells them that I can when others say I can't. I can do all things through Christ. Samson had a spirit of a person who said I can, because no matter what you say about his life, God had a word over his life. And a word over your life will sustain you all the way to the end of your life. I wish I had some help right there. Regardless of what he did or anything that anybody else did, it didn't keep him from getting to where God said he was going to get to. Sometimes you have to look within your life and say that it really doesn't matter, because if God has ordained me to anything, nobody can stop me from getting to where God said that I'm going to go. Quit fainting because nothing is working in your life. Quit fainting because you're in a rough place and you hit a rough patch in your life. Sometimes you have to believe God even in places when you don't see what God is doing. You have to make up your mind that even if I fail, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. My life is subject to the word. God says that I'm going to use you, Samson, to begin to deliver the children of Israel from their enemies. And that word saved his life. And I don't know about you, but that's what the word does. It saves your life. Because whenever God speaks a word to you, it really doesn't matter what happens after it. Whatever God said, everything else will have to give way to the word that God spoke over you. It really doesn't matter who want to see you dead. If a word of God is over your life, you can step in front of a bus. You'll still live. Do I have anybody who's been in some serious wrecks and you can't figure out yet how it is that you're sitting here and ain't got no harm at all? Because there's a word over you. When there's a word over you, you can call the ambulance if you want to. But there's nothing that's going to happen to me, because there's a word that's sustaining me. A word commands your ultimate end. No matter who sets traps against you, no matter who don't believe in you, it will never change what God has already said about you. God said, I know the plans I have for you. They're good and not evil, to bring you to your expected end. Somebody shout expected end. And what that means is that whatever God expects out of you, he'll get out of you, regardless of what anybody else think is going to become of you. Don't let people talk out down your future. You got to believe in your future yourself, because whenever God start rising you up, honey, it'll confuse all of them. And in fact, sometimes it'll confuse you. Is there anybody in here beside me wonder sometimes why folk are jealous jealous of you and why it is that they are looking and impressed with you, because you know that ain't nothing about you, but that's a word over you. Because when there's a word, word speaks favor. Folk look at you and you can still be broke and don't have a job, but no wonder they're jealous, because they're not looking at your present. They've already peeped into your future. There's something about when God starts speaking favor over your life. Favor reduces the odds and calls those things that be not as though they already are. And it looks like when people got favor, it looks like before favor started manifesting itself, it always looks worse. Do I have anybody who's been there? Honey, if your life looks jacked up now, don't worry about it, because God's getting ready to flip the strip, turn the thing all the way around. He's getting ready to cause your bad days to become good days, because that's what favor does. It has to switch, because everybody can't see where you're going. If they saw where you're going before you got there, they do more to stop you. But God has to sneak you up on some people. Do I have anybody in here that you, when folks saw you, it was just bam. They don't even know how come it is that you're so blessed. They don't know how it is that you got where you are. That's why, baby, you don't worry about what people say when God start raising and blessing you. Don't worry. When you get the car, quit trying to convince folk that you shouldn't have it. Go ahead and drive it and put your gas in it and pull up in front of their house and blow your horn, because they wasn't there when you were walking, and they wasn't there when you had to hoop it, when you had to pray all day long with something that you wonder if was going to start. But you learned when God did it, act like he did it. You don't have to be arrogant. You don't have to take credit. Say, it's the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our sight. Slap your neighbor, high five, and say, God did it. Yes, I don't have to brag, honey, because God did it. God did it. When God did it, honey, folk can get confused about it inside, and you don't even have to take credit of it. That's why blessed people are humble people. Do I have any witnesses in here? Honey, sometimes when you're blessed, you don't say nothing. You just let everybody else talk. I hear you. I know, but it's the Lord. It's the Lord. It's a word over me, and word favors me. The word is the reason that I got the raise. Word is the reason why I got promoted, and they said it was on a freeze. Isn't it crazy how God blesses you when everybody else say that you ain't gonna be blessed? The blessings of the Lord make rich, and he has no sorrow. Even when people hate you, if there's a word over you, that word will somehow produce something in you. You remember Joseph lived in the house with these people that hated him and plotted against him, but they couldn't destroy him because God has spoken a word over him, because they would think evil against you. But God, if God meant it for good, baby, it really doesn't matter what anybody say. With all the people that wanted Samson dead, he still lived because there was a word over him. And some things he would have left that he went through would left everybody else for dead, but he kept coming back because a word over him. Honey, the Bible says he leaves and goes to the hills, leaves his people and goes to the hills of the Philistines, and he falls in love with a woman there, and he decides to marry her. But on his way back home, he is attacked by a lion, and he grabs it and rips it into pieces because there's something happened.
Hi, I'm Pastor Charles Rogers with the Hope Community Church. You know, living here in the Tennessee Valley, one thing we know is that nothing that we have in this life is certain. In fact, we found out that life itself is not always certain. The only sure thing we do have is our relationship with Jesus Christ. I want to invite you and your entire family to come and worship with the Hope Community family as we seek that relationship with God together. Thank you.